Please, can you put your hands together for me to bring up our beloved brother and pastor, Bode Akindele, to deliver what the Lord has put in his hand for his body, even tonight. God bless you, sir.
Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Amen. We thank God for the word we have already heard. It's already flowing from the altar of grace. And I know that this weekend, God is going to fill us up to overflow in Jesus' name. His grace, his mercies will speak, and none of us will be left out in the name of Jesus. Let's begin to thank God for this year. Just thank him for what he's yet going to do for you and me. Begin to thank him in appreciation, in hope, in faith. Thank him for what he will still do. Thank him for what he has done, but what he will still do in your life this year, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's begin to appreciate him, exalt him, magnify him. He's a good and faithful God. He's a reliable and trustworthy God. He's a dependable, mighty God. We thank you, Father, for what you've done, but we thank you for what you will still do. We appreciate you for what you've done, but we thank you for what you will still do in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Father, every second we will spend tonight and tomorrow night, Saturday night and Sunday morning, Father, we commend to you. You've already begun with us, and thank you for beginning to expand your word to us already. But Lord of heaven, let every second be packed with your blessings. Let your grace flow in these gatherings. Let your name be glorified as we come together. My Lord in heaven, let none of us be left out, O God, as you pass, O God. Don't pass any of us by. Give us encounter unique to each person, to the glory and praise of your name. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Shout hallelujah. Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus Christ again tonight. Hallelujah. We may be seated. Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, this is an awesome night because I'm grateful for the two words we have already heard. The flowing line directly from even the notes that I have made part of them. Now, here is the bottom line I want to establish as we get close to the end of 2016, as we get close to the end of this year, getting ready for the new beginning of a new year. God has given a word for us and is going to use that word to not only bless us now, but also usher us into a new realm of experience in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, many times when we want to close a phase and begin another phase, what you really need is a word from God. Now, it is when the word from God comes, the light shines upon your path. When the word comes, it prepares the way for you. When the word comes, it comes a base of anchoring your faith. The Bible says the just shall live by faith. Now, if the word of God comes to you and your faith is anchored, it doesn't matter what the wind that blows. It doesn't matter what the storms that come. God's word that has been sent to you to anchor you, will uphold you through the thick and the thin of the time and the come that is going to come. So shall it be for us in Jesus' name. God has given me an assignment to declare to you as a church, and those that are going to hear this by CD or any means, that you will see the glory of God. And I have come to declare unto you, you will see the glory of God in the name of Jesus Christ. In this year that is yet remaining, and in the year that we are about to enter, you will see the glory of God in the land of the living, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, you will help me to do the same thing to your friend now. Tell him, face somebody and say, you will see the glory of God. Now, look for somebody else. Say, you will see the glory of God. Now, look for the third person. You will see the glory of God. In the name of Jesus, you will experience the glory of the Lord in the land of the living, in Jesus' name. Now, when we get to heaven, you will see glory, yes. But we are talking about the land of the living. When Martha was telling Jesus, yes, I know he will appear on the last day. Jesus was saying, no, I'm not talking about the last day. I'm talking about now. The resurrection and life is here. So we're not talking about resurrection in glory. There is a glory in heaven, but there is a glory on earth. God is declaring to us that the glory of God, which is available and applicable to us here on earth, you will partake of it. Say after me, I will see the glory of God in the land of the living, in the name of Jesus Christ. Now listen, from this day, I don't care what the weather say, what the newscasters say, what your neighbors say, what your paycheck say, what your bank balance say, or what your doctor's report say. Say after me, I will see the glory of God in the land of the living. Make that your confession. Make a commitment to make that your declaration. It shall be as you declare in the name of Jesus Christ. God will surprise you. You see, men will say that's a casting down. You will say that's a lifting up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. When people are in trouble, what they ask for, Lord, show me your glory. You see, in the year we are about to get into, in fact, in the weeks ahead of you, if you don't have a prayer point, I'll give you one. And it's simple. You can pray for 3 hours in the spirit. All you are asking for, Lord, show me your glory. Lord, show me your glory. I'm going to share with you many instances where the glory of God is revealed. The glory of God revealed is not just the ecstasy that we experience when we come to church. It's not just the ecstasy of the presence of God in worship. The glory of God we see is revealed, manifested in the diverse ways of declaring the presence, the power, the mercy, the love of the Most High God. You will find that what is declared and described as the manifestation of the glory of God goes beyond ecstasy. Hallelujah. So when finances are down and you don't know what to do, what must you say? I will see the glory of God. When you went to the doctor's office and you came back with a feedback, you don't know how to deal with it, what must you say? I will see the glory of God. And don't stop there. Say, I will see the glory of God in this land of the living. In the name of Jesus. Now, the Bible says the just shall live by faith. In the years ahead of us, formulas doesn't work the way we thought them to be. In the years ahead of us, predictions may not work the way people think they will be. There will be a difference between they that serve God and they that do not serve God. So what you declare is that you will see the glory of God no matter what the experience may be. That one will not fail. That one will not fail. That's what God has asked me to declare to you. In this land of the living, you will see the glory of God. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, Psalm 27, verse 13. Let's begin from there. Psalm 27, verse 13. The Bible says, I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord. Now, this is what the psalmist was saying here. He was singing praise to God for the deliverance he obtained before and was anchoring his faith ahead of him based on that deliverance experience, and he was using that to declare that I know that things are terrible and hard. If I look at the way things look, I will faint. But I will not faint because I believe I will see the glory of God in the land of the living. Amen? So if you look very closely at that scripture, he was anchoring his faith and his heart in hope. He was anchoring his heart in hope. Look at verse 5. I'm reading from the Good News Version in verse 5 of the same Psalm 27. It says, in times of trouble, he will shelter me. He will keep me safe in his temple. Make me secure on a high rock. In time of trouble, he will keep me safe. He will shelter me. Now, all these declarations he was making were based on verdicts he had to make because of the experience he has had of what God did for him before. Hallelujah. Look at verse 3. Even if a whole army surrounds me, I will not be afraid. Even if enemies attack me, I will still trust God. Now, all these are made because of the experience he had. Look at that in Message version of verse 3. When besieged, I'm calm as a baby. When all hell break loose, I'm collected, I'm cool. That's in the Message version. When all hell break loose, I'm collected and cool. As you begin a new phase of your year, it doesn't matter what hell is breaking loose. I declare to you, you'll be cool, you'll be calm in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever the nation may be saying, today I think the president is defending his budget for next year. Whatever the budget he defended, God is your source. Even if when besieged, you will come as a baby. Even if when all hell breaks loose, you will be collected and you'll be cool. In the name of Jesus Christ. When they declare the budget, what would you say? I will see the glory of the Lord in the land of the living. When they say there's a fuel price change, what would you say? I will see the glory of the Lord in the land of... That's your confession that God has asked me to put in your mouth. It will not fail. It will work for you. It will sustain you. It will be a defense for you. It will be like an anchor for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, look at that scripture. Now, why is he saying that? It's because of his experience. Look at verse 13. He says, I had fainted unless I had believed. I had fainted unless I had believed. I had fainted unless I had believed. Why did he not faint? Verse 2 says it this way. When the wicked came against me to eat up my flesh, my enemies and foes, in the New King James Version, they stumbled and fell. This is a report. So verse 13 says, even now things are bad. I would have fainted if I didn't believe that was going to be a deliverance. But why am I not fainting now? It's because before he did it before. He did it before in verse 2. When my enemies came against me. When things were so bad. When I was besieged. When it seems the end of the world had come. God came around on my behalf. So when things are now terrible, I won't be fainting. I will believe that I will see the glory of the Lord in this land of the living. So he was more or less praising God and using his experience. If you go half time, go look at the whole chapter. Using experience to now anchor his faith in the years ahead of him, in the steps he's about to take. Amen? Amen? So as you close this season of your life in the name of Jesus Christ, no matter what men say, this is your confession. I will see the glory of God. Now, if you don't confess this, you may faint. If you look at the way things physically, you may be staggered. You may be disturbed. You may be perplexed. You may be perturbed. But God will not allow that in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Now look at Exodus 33, verse 18. I'm going to spend a few minutes in the book of Exodus 33. Moses was having an encounter with God here. In fact, put verse 1 first for us. Exodus 33, verse 1. Verse 1 says, then the Lord said to Moses, depart and go up from here. You and the people whom you have brought out of the land of Egypt, to the land of which I swore to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, saying, to your descendants I will give it. So God was speaking to Moses here. It's time to move to the next level. to enter into what I promised you. So it was a journey in the presence and in the front of Moses. And Moses knew he couldn't do it by himself. I mean, you know that he really couldn't do it by himself. All the journey they had to make in the book of Exodus, he knew from time, even from the time they left Egypt, crossed the Red Sea, all the wilderness experiences, he knows it's not so easy. So when God was speaking to him, now go further, he's saying, look, I can't go anywhere from here except you show forth with us. So in verse 18, he said, show me your glory. He said, show me your glory. And what did God say to him? God answered to him and said, I will make all my goodness pass before thee. Everybody say goodness. Everybody say goodness. You see, when you're asking for God's glory, you are also asking for God's goodness. So I will make all my goodness to pass before you. Moses was asking simple questions. What he was asking for is the manifestation of the presence of God. So it is called goodness. Goodness is also described as pleasantness. So the glory of God is the manifest presence of God that makes a difference between us and others. The glory of God is what makes a difference between us and others. It is the manifest presence of God that makes a difference between us and others. So when you are saying you will see the glory of God, what you are saying is that you are going to see the manifest presence of God with you, which makes a difference between you and the other people. Hallelujah. Now, let me read that scripture to you from the New Living Translations, verse 15 and verse 16. If you have the New Living Translation, that would be great. Excellent. Moses said, if you don't personally go with us, don't make us leave this place. Look at the next verse. How will anyone know that you look favorably on me and on your people, if you don't go with us? Then look at that. For your presence, everybody say presence. See, when he said, show me your glory, what did God say? I will show you my presence. I will show you my goodness. Then he now said, for your presence amongst us, set your people and me apart from other people on the earth. Glory to God. When you declare and say, Lord, show me your glory, what are you saying? You are saying, Lord, give me a Goshen experience. So the Bible says, your presence is what makes a difference between us and other people. What that means is you will have a unique experience based on God's word, based on God's promises, not based on what the weather say, not based on what the budget say, not based on what epidemic is going through. Look, the world is going through turmoil, and it's going to increase because we're in the last days. But you see, in the midst of it, God will separate his own children for those that don't know him. So for those that will walk through this earth in this phase and in this season by faith, all they are asking for, Lord, make your goodness to go before me. Give me an experience of the manifest presence of the Most High God. And in saying all that, you are saying, Lord, show me your glory. Moses, I don't think he understood what he was asking for. No. God had to reveal to him a little bit more. He said, Lord, show me your glory. God said, no, you can't even handle it. What you really want is my presence. What you really want is my goodness. What you really want is my pleasantness. I'll give you. Hallelujah. I'll give you. So when God spoke to me to speak to you and you will see the glory of God, it will be pleasant with you. In the name of Jesus Christ. At work, it will be pleasant with you. In school, it will be pleasant with you. On the road, it will be pleasant with you. Even in your bathroom, it will be pleasant with you. In the name of Jesus. That's what God is saying. Now, hear what God says in verse 17 and 18. 17 to 19 is a discussion now. Let me read it again with you. He says, and the Lord said to Moses, I will do this thing also, that's verse 17, that thou hast spoken. This is King James now. For thou hast found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. I'm going to come back to those two important things. You have found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. You have found grace in my sight, and I know thee by name. Those are things that have opened the door for you to be able to even answer, to receive the request you are making. Then look at verse 18. It says, and he said, I beseech you, show me your glory. Verse 19 says, and he said, I will make all my goodness pass before thee, and I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee. Oh, God. You see, the word proclaim there, if you have time, go study the word proclaim. I will pronounce and call to attention the name of the Lord before you. Hallelujah. I will proclaim the name of the Lord before thee, and will be gracious to whom I be gracious, and will show mercy unto whom I will show mercy. So the word proclaim, the word of the Lord proclaim. Can we try and see other versions that will help us get insight into that word in verse 19? He says, I will make all my goodness pass before thee. Just flip through other translations first. He says, I will be gracious to you. No, I will make all my goodness pass before thee. I'll proclaim the name of Jehovah before thee. Now go back to good news. I will pronounce my sacred name. Go back to Amplified. I will proclaim my name. I'm looking for another word that is used that's not proclaim. I will declare, I will call to attention my name. I will call to attention my name. You see, when you see a king going anywhere, the king is coming. The king is coming. They will be making sound in front of him. There will be a declaration of the magnificence, of the power, of the beauty, of the ability, of the capacity of that king going ahead of him. So when he says, I will proclaim my name before, he says, I will call out the name God. Shandelebo Satahaya. All that Moses was asking for, show me your glory. He didn't understand what it means. Verse 18, Moses said, show me your glory. God said, let me give you a simple understanding of what it means to show me your glory. I will call to attention the word God is going before you. Shande, Luce, Kato. You see, what can stand before the name God? What can stand before the name Jehovah? What can withstand the power of the Most High God? And God says, I will call it to attention. So that as you go, men will know you are arriving. So shall be your portion. In the name of Jesus, I proclaim on you and your household, it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus. You call his name once, he answers you by himself. Hallelujah. And then God said, I am the one that will do it. Hey. I will call out the name God right before you. I'll treat well whoever I want to treat well. I'll be kind to whoever I want to be kind to. Then it says, I will show you, mercy, because you have found grace before me, and I know you by name. You see, don't imagine you are just a normal, average person. You have found grace before me, and I know thee by name. I like to say this. I like to make this clear to us. You see, in a church like this, we thank God we know each other. You can believe everybody is born again. But being born again is much more precious than when people think. All right? Going to church doesn't cut the cake at all. Being born again cuts the cake. You have found grace before me, and I know you by name. Ha. That covenant, that's priceless. You can't walk with God half-heartedly. You can't relate with him as if I just go to church. No, he says, I know you by name, so what you say matter to me. When your word carry weight in heaven, that makes the difference. Hallelujah. Where are my friends? You are more precious to me. You know that. I like the old people. You are more precious to me than them. But you see, when your work carry away before God, that's what matters. Until then, we are playing. See, I will do what you asked me. You know, Moses was asking, don't let us go out of here without your presence. He goes, I will do it. Don't worry. Not only that, I will call the name God before you. It pays to serve Jesus. It pays to cut covenant with God. In the years ahead, the people whose voice will matter in the presence of God are those who have found grace before him and those whose name he knows. There's nothing that can withstand a consecrated heart to God. There is no price to pay that is too much for you to say, God must know me. There's no price too much to pay to say, I will please my God. I will not allow the sin of this world to hinder the weight I carry in the presence of God. You know, when God says, you have found grace before me, why would he separate those two words? Anybody who is born again has found grace before God. By grace are you saved, through faith, not of works, lest any man should boast. Hallelujah. And he says, I know your name. Hey! That's where the key is. That's where the key. Does he know your name? Can you say every moment of your life, God reckons with me? With God, it's easy to get what you want if you pay the price or if you fulfill the conditions. As a church, we want to say, as we begin a new year, that's our commitment. God must know my name. My name must ring a bell in his presence all the time. I'm not going to walk away from his presence. I'm not going to follow evil with other men. You see, many people will come and tempt you with evil as we begin. Things are getting more terrible and people are getting more crafty. But when God knows your name, he will declare his name by himself before you as you make progress in life. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we are talking about you will see the glory of God. So God said in verse 19, and he said, I will make all my goodness. Everybody say, all my goodness. All my pleasantness. So when you're asking, Lord, show me your glory. All my goodness will be available to you. Everybody say, show me your glory. You are sending God all your goodness. I want to see it. Ah, I'm serious. And God himself is answering you. I will show you all my goodness. I don't want you to be afraid for the years ahead of you, brethren. No, there's no need to. Now, I'm saying this ahead before things may look negative. I'm saying this ahead even before your personal life may look challenging, and so that your faith will be anchored in this truth. Don't let a contrary word come out of your mouth. Even when you think about your state in life and they don't look so great, what must you say? What must you say? What must you say? And the more you declare that word, you are pulling down the name God before you. The more you declare that word, you are pulling down the word goodness of God before you. The more you declare that word, you are bringing pleasantness of God come to speedily answer to your questions. And that's the only way to win the battles that we're about to enter into. That's the only way. Financial battles, marital battles, you know, children battles, business battles, health battles, whatever it is. So when David said, I had fainted unless I had believed I would see the goodness of God in the land of the living, he knew what he was talking about. So even when everything wants to make you faint, what must you say? That's the peak of my assignment on this mission. And if you are anchored in this truth, it shall be well with you. In the name of Jesus Christ. So the next 2-3 days, we're going to be taking different examples where the glory of God manifested. Sometimes you will see impossible cases, just like the one that was shared with you earlier on. And you will notice that glory also still manifests in very impossible cases. Look at Psalm 63, verse 1 to 2, Psalm 63. King James Version says, O God, thou art my God. Psalm 63, early will I seek thee. My soul thirsts for thee. My flesh long for thee in a dry and thirsty land where no water is. What a description. What a description. See, there is an opposite scenario presented here. One of them is a dry and thirsty land where there's no water. And then the next verse, verse 2 says, to see your power and your glory. Hallelujah. When you see God's power and glory, then the dry and thirsty experience, the vamoose. So David, from experience, he knows when God shows up, things change. So here he said, Lord, I'm in a thirsty land. My soul is thirsty. My flesh is longing. I'm in a place where it's dry. I'm in a place where there seems to be no water. Things, nothing seems to be working. Lord, what do I need? You see, he knows what he needs when he's in sessions that are not working. He knows what he needs. He knows what he needs is the glory and the power of God. Oh, my soul seek for you. Oh, my heart longs for you. Oh, it's so dry and difficult. Lord, what do I need? Show me your glory and power. Show me your glory and power. Exactly what David was saying here. And the Bible says, he says, so as I have seen thee in the sanctuary. You know what that means? I know what you can do. I've seen it before. When you manifest your presence, when your glory is revealed, when your power is revealed, all these thirsty experiences will go. So, he now said that, he says, oh God, thou art, if you look at that psalm, it's so deep. Oh God, thou art my God. It was a cry born out of a pang in the heart. Oh God. Just that word, oh God, alone has a meaning. Oh God. Oh God. Thou art my God. Oh God. So why am I in this thirsty land, in this dry land? Oh God. You see, when he's in a thirsty and dry land, he knew what to do. What did he do? He cried unto God. And he did that early. And he was asking for just two things. Show me your power. Show me your glory. I've seen it before. I know based on what I saw before. If it can show forth again, I'm okay. I'm all right. Hallelujah. So you don't go into situations and you go wondering, what do I do? No, David, oh God. You are my God. So I'm okay. Because I know that's settled. So I can't tarry so long in this situation. I know I have access into your presence. I know you know my name. I know I have found grace before you. So what I saw before, bring it again. You see, God can do it again. God will do it again. And again and again. He's the same God today. As he always has been, yesterday and forever, is always the same. There's no reason to doubt. God will do it again. So David was saying, I know you can do it again. Oh God, but you are my God. Take me out of here. Hallelujah. So when things are hard and terrible, don't look for any other place. Just look up to him. Hallelujah. Look up to him. So that was a cry of David for his glory, for his power, which he saw before. in the sanctuary. Hallelujah. The glory of God that you saw before in the sanctuary. Now, if you look through the scripture, in the Old Testament, there is a meaning of the word glory. And in the New Testament, there's also a meaning of the same word glory in the Hebrew and in the Greek. Let me just run through quickly what they mean and the different times where they've used the word glory. Now, the word glory in the Old Testament means kavod. Kavod in the Old Testament. It means weight. Weight. For something to be weighty. It also means numerous. All right? I want to see your glory. Numerous. It also means honor. That means it's the same word that is used in Malachi 1:6. Honor. Say, if I be a father unto you, where is my honor? So, the honor of God. Then it says esteem. So when you are saying, Lord, show me your glory, what you're saying is that I want to see, experience weighty experiences, numerous in my life. Esteem. I want my life to esteem you. Hallelujah. Renown also is the word renown, glory. Also means majesty. I want to see the manifestation of the majesty of God. So the word means weight, it means numerous, it means honor, it means esteem, it means renown, it means majesty. So when I say, show me your glory, Lord, manifest your majesty in my life. Now it's a word used to describe the personality of a person. Oh, it's glorious, you know, that kind of stuff. You know, so in some instances in the Bible, it's used to describe the personality and the capacity of God. When Abraham was crying and asking the Lord, what am I going to, are you going to give me sin? I go childless. Bible says in the book of Romans that he did not doubt God. He was giving glory to God. Hallelujah. He was giving glory to God. So his childlessness at the end of the day brought glory to God. His childlessness brought glory to God. When Jesus was speaking to Martha that you will see the glory of God, he's saying that you will see my capacity. You will see my workings. You will see my ability. You will see what will bring praise to me. Hallelujah. So the word glory, esteem, honor, renown, and majesty. So when you are saying, Lord, show me your glory, it means in this situation, let there be praise to your name. Hallelujah. In this circumstance, let men know your renown. Let it be renowned that you manifested yourself. Hallelujah. So when we are saying, show me your glory, we are not just saying, let me feel the goose pimple that God was here. No. It's like when you are crying, you couldn't even pray. When you are panging, when you are ashamed, when men seems to be ridiculing you, and you are asking, Lord, show me your glory in this situation, where you are saying that, God, let men know you are majestic. Let your renown be made bare in my situation. Let your praise come forth from this kind of experience. That's what you are simply saying. So the word glory is weight, numerous, honor, renown, esteem, majesty. Amen? Power. An ability of a person. It's used to describe the power and the ability of God. So when you're saying, Lord, show me your glory, let me see your power. That was what David was saying in the book of Psalms. He says, Lord, that I will see your glory and your power. As I saw in the temple. So the word glory is as abundance. Abundance. If you look at Genesis 31 verse 1. Let's look at Genesis 31 verse 1. And see, when we're describing Laban's sons, they were describing the abundance of flock and wealth that Jacob had gotten from working with their father. The word that we use there in verse 1 says, now Jacob heard the words of Laban's sons, saying, Jacob has taken away all that was our father, and from what was our father's, as he acquired all this wealth. All right? Now notice it now before we go to other versions. As he acquired all his what? all this wealth. And go to King James Version. All the word it says, of that which was our father, as he had gotten all this what? Glory. So glory, wealth, abundance speak of the same thing. So when your finances are down and you are saying, Lord, show me your glory. What are you saying? Bring wealth to me. Hallelujah. So when things are back, you check your balance and it doesn't seem to be speaking what you thought it would speak. And instead of people complaining and thinking of how to make money more, what must you cry first? Lord, show me your glory. You look at the bank, you are in front of the ATM. People are queuing behind you. You pull the card. It didn't show a balance you didn't expect. You say, Lord, show me your glory. People are wondering, what is he saying, show me your glory in front of ATM? They don't get it. Show me your glory here. Hallelujah. You go away. The next time you put your card, what will you see? Wealth. You are calling glory down. Don't ease in front of your ATM and be complaining. Don't do that. Just say, Lord, show me your glory. Hallelujah. That's the antidote that you need for all the experience you're going to have. Amen. So the word glory there is wealth, abundance, numerous. How many people are wanting more children? Today, 1 month ago today, I became a grandfather. So I want more grandchildren. I don't want more children. More grandchildren. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The children is enough. Let the grandchildren begin to flow now. You want more children? Oh, you are single. My heart goes to the singles in this church. I'm praying for you. When you say, show me your glory, what you are saying is show me your beauty. You see, glory describes the beauty of God over your life. So don't begin to say, Lord, when will you do it? Just say, Lord, show me your glory. Show me your glory. It is answer to every single question that any man can face. It's a word of declaration. It's a tool of power. It brings breakthrough where the enemy thought he has captured you. David said, I'm in a dry and thirsty land. God, I want to see your glory and your power as I saw in the temple. That's the way to do it. Complaining won't do it. Declaring will do it. What must you declare? What God said. He spoke to me to tell you, you will see the glory of God in the land of the living. And so shall it be. In the name of Jesus, wealth is coming your way. Abundance is coming your way. In the New Testament, the word glory is called for recognition, acclaim, reputation. Recognition, acclaim, reputation. So that's recognition belonging to a person. Acclaim belonging to a person. Honor or renown belonging to a person. All right? So recognition, acclaim, reputation. Amen? So when my life does not describe the capacity and the personality of God, and I'm saying, Lord, show me your glory. But I'm simply saying that let it be clear that you have, let your reputation show in my life. Amen? And all of this we're going to see as we go through tomorrow and next of the instances where that word is used and how it applies to us. And what God wants to show us, therefore, is as we close this year, He wants to show Himself strong in your life. As we close this year, He wants to show His reputation. He wants to tell you, is it me? There's nothing I cannot do. I will bring it to pass because I'm able to do it in Jesus' name. Amen. The word in Genesis 13:2, I think we look at that earlier on. The word glory is used as a description of the abundance of God. Genesis 13:2. The same word glory is used to describe here riches. Abraham was very rich in livestock, in silver, and in gold. If you look at the original word used for riches there, it's glory. And I spent time to look into, you see, in the Bible, there is a many, many times what glory is used, all right? But the kind of Bible I used to study, they will put the one that I'm talking about. It has a number. All of the many instances where the word the same number appears, those are the different meanings that I saw there. So the word was rich there, his glory. So you are saying, God, show me your glory, show me your wealth. That is manifesting my life. It's not impossible for God to do in the name of Jesus Christ. So glory also means what? Riches. Amen? Matthew 6:29. Now this was Jesus speaking here. Go to the King James Version of Matthew 6:29. He says, and yet I say unto you, this was Jesus speaking. And yet I say unto you, and even Solomon, in all of his glory, was not arrayed like one of these. So Jesus was describing the things that Solomon had as what? A form of what? Glory. And if you look through 1 Kings chapter 10, from verse 1 to 10, Queen Sheba was describing the glory of Solomon there. Look at the way he described it from 1 Kings chapter 10, verse 1 to 10. He says, and when the queen of Sheba heard of the fame of Solomon. Now, Jesus used one word to describe all of this. One word. What was the word? What was the word? One more time. All right, now look at that one word which Jesus used to summarize it. Look at all the meaning. The reason why I'm taking time to expatiate on this is because faith comes by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. We must not be half-hearted when it comes to the multi-dimension of what the word of God means. This recently, an analogy came to my mind about an elephant, a big elephant. I've heard the story before. If you take two people or three people to an elephant, you blindfold their eyes before you took them to the elephant, and you place them on different sides of the elephant, people that you blindfold them, you tell them to feel what is in front of them and describe what they see, in quote. They can't see, but they can feel. And they describe what they feel. Somebody on the side of the elephant will say, I see a flat level. Isn't it so? Because his hand, by the time you stretch your hand, all you are touching is just a flat side. Take somebody up around the neck and the head. What do you feel? You say, I see a long something that I can feel a long, big pipe. Something. Take someone to the backside. I can see long. They will give you different description. Open their eyes while they are seen by the elephant. They will collapse. I didn't know it was in front of the elephant. Everyone will view with a portion they can only feel. But in the word of God, it's multi-sided. I want to comprehend the totality of God. The glory of God comes when we are in worship. The power of God comes and heals. Boom, boom, boom. That's glory. The glory of God when we're in the worship. And the Bible says the minister could not even stand to speak. That's glory. But the glory of God comes when you appear and the word God is proclaimed in front of you. That's glory. And when glory is describing your wealth, that's glory. So God doesn't only want to show forth his power as you heal the sick and set the captives free, but he wants to show his power as you are wealthy and rich. He also wants to show his power as you increase your and set you in your own home. That's glory. Hallelujah. So if you look through what Jesus was speaking about glory as far as Solomon was concerned, it's amazing. It's not anything about the presence of God that is, you know, that is there and the Spirit of God was moving. No, it's fame, wealth, money, all the kind of arrangement of his house. Amen? So you don't want to go to your house and everything is haphazard. When you say that this is glorious, not so much about the expense, but about the order. It's also glorious. Hallelujah. So look at that scripture now. As I've given enough preamble. When Queen of Sheba heard of the fame of Solomon concerning the name of the Lord, she came to prove him with questions. Verse 2. And she came to Jerusalem with a very great train, with camels that bear spices, very much gold, precious stones. When she came to Solomon, she communed with him of all that was in her heart. I want you to listen to this very well. Verse 3. Solomon told her all her questions. There was not anything hid from the king, which he told her not. When the queen of Sheba had seen all of Solomon's wisdom, oh, glory to God, they will see your wisdom. What does it mean to see wisdom? His wisdom was palpable. All of this, what was one word Christ used to describe it? Say, even Solomon in all dimensions of his glory. Hallelujah. I want you to go with me. Men will see your wisdom. The things you know to do that was not yet paying up for you, it will come to fall. People will be willing to pay for it. In the name of Jesus. When Queen of Sheba saw, he saw all of his glory, all of his wisdom, sorry, and the house that he has built, has glory. The house he built, the wisdom by which he spoke. Verse 5 is funny. The meat of his table, the sitting of his servants, the attendance of his ministers, their apparel, the cupbearers, the ascent by which he went up to the house of the Lord. There was no more spirit in her. You know what that means? She passed out. There was so much order, so much wealth, so much glory, the lady fainted. I want you to hear me well. When you are saying, Lord, show me your glory, it includes this. There's something about a circumcised heart that can bear the glory of God. You see, that's what a crucified life and a disciple's heart will be. But a crucified life and a disciple's heart is not a poverty appearance. No! But a man who is not sanctified, crucified, and not a disciple in his heart, when his small glory comes, he's pumping. He's pumping up. None of these things move me. It doesn't make a difference. Paul said, I know how to abound and how to abase. I'm not glorying in those things. But glory belongs to you. Because you see, when God knows you can handle his wealth, he will give it to you. When God knows you can handle his power, he will give it to you. So power, wealth, abundance is glory. The reason why many people have it and they lose it is because they don't know how to manage it. And then instead of them bringing glory to God, they bring disdain to God. And God is not happy about that. But when you have access to what God has and you're going to lay hold on it and use it to the benefit of the mankind, God is still not happy with you. May your ears open. May your understanding be enlightened. In the name of Jesus Christ. You will go from grace to grace. From strength to strength. From wealth to wealth. From glory to glory. In the name of Jesus. These are explicit and clear. It is the word of Jesus. All this is glory. And it says, even all this glory is not comparable to what the least in this house has. That's what Jesus said. Even the least in this house has more than this as far as potential. Simon, listen. I want all of you that are working for yourself, lift your hands to heaven. No matter what business you do, you will prosper. You will bring great wealth. You will go from grace to grace. In the name of Jesus. It belongs to the house of God. Your mind must not be small. Your thinking must not be limited. You will see the glory of God. Glory means acclaim, honor, manifestation of God's power. So when people see you working, what would they say? That's glory going. You will be a description. The Bible says, these people have I formed for myself. They will show forth my praise. So when you walk around in your department, don't just because you are wearing tie, they will say that's glory. Why? They see your wisdom. You present one paper, they'll say, that paper is first class journal. That's glory. That's glory. Don't say, let my people go. Don't go and get 40 and be saying I passed. Yes, you passed, but that's not glory. That guy is beauty, he's brilliant. That's glory. That's what attracted me to Christ. The guy that invited me to church was brilliant. And he said, we have youth meetings. You know, that was informed all this youth event that is at the back of my mind. Because that's how I got born again. Well, in the same class, was brilliant. He invited me to church on Saturday afternoon for youth meeting where they are teaching them integrated science and English and whatever it is. And I said, I will come. At that time, I was still doing double practice of my Islam and my English and my Christianity at the same time. And I got there, and they were teaching them science. I said, maybe that's why this man is brilliant. They teach us science, they play some games, and then they say, if you want to come tomorrow, we also do it tomorrow after church service. I will come. I went. Before I knew it, Sunday morning, in that first square church, I got born again. What attracted me? Glory. What kind of glory? Brilliant boy. Don't play around with your studies, please. I beg you. Don't play around with us. Don't 40%, 55%. No. Say, I will see the glory of God in the land of the living. So as you begin a new academic year, glory is you study hard, you make it well. That's glory. I don't want half-hearted, half-knowledge, religious mindset. I see great people here. I see great wealth here. Even those who are yet to come, I see them here. In the name of Jesus, you will go from strength to strength, from grace to grace, from height to height. And then God spoke to that guy and said, I will do what you are asking me to do. Why? You have found grace before me. And two, I know your name. That's why he told Moses, I will do what you are asking for two reasons. You have found grace before me, that means you are born again, and I know your name. Your name carry weight in my presence. If you can fulfill those two conditions, there is no limit to your wealth on this earth. So don't fulfill those two conditions as you walk in poverty or look as if you are poor. You don't need that kind of a claim of recognition or description or personality. Too sharp. And wake up. Men want to see your wisdom. They will see it. In your organization, you know, I've told you, it's going places. Don't think small. Don't limit what you're going to do there. Put order in your business. Where is that lady who sells food? Simon, where's your wife? Put order. Is she hearing me, though? All the big multinational business people started in their garage. May you hear me well today. This weekend, your life will be forever transformed. In the name of Jesus Christ. Shout hallelujah. He said, she fainted. You know what the funny thing she said? Verse 6. And she said to the king, it was true, the report that I heard in my own hand, my own land, of the acts of your acts and of your wisdom. How be it, I believed not the words until I came. My eyes have seen it, and behold, the half was not told me. Half was not told me. Now, what she did not believe was not even up to half of the reality. And she said, no, that's true. You can't mean it. It's impossible. You mean a man will have that? No. I will go and see myself. So she got there and found that even all the ones she was saying no to is not up to half of the reality of what is happening. And then she said in verse 7 says, and then it says, thy wisdom, look at that. Thy wisdom, verse 7, thy prosperity exceed the fame that I had. What is all this one? What did Jesus describe all this? You will see the glory of God in the land of the living. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now look at verse 8. Happy are your men. Happy are these your servants. This is glory. This is glory. Happy are your men. Happy are these your servants, which stand continually before you and hear thy wisdom. Blessed be the Lord thy God, who delight in thee to set thee on the throne of Israel, because of the Lord loveth Israel forever. Therefore made thee king to do judgment and justice. And then she gave the king 120 talents of gold and of spices, very great store, precious stones. There came no more such abundance of spices as this, which the queen of Sheba gave to King Solomon. Let me describe to you what happened. Do I have a few more minutes? Let me describe to you what happened. This was a presidential visit with our entourage. Secretary of State was there. Minister of Foreign Affairs was there. Minister of Trade and Industry was there. Everybody was there. Some leaders of business enterprise were there. We're going to see this man who they say is wealthy. She came with a private jet. She got there. With all that she thought she had, she bowed. Men will bow to you. In the name of Jesus Christ. May your faith take it. And I go back to the two conditions that God gave to Moses. You found grace in my sight. I know your name. Hey, you see, it's so easy to get glory. Because God himself said, I will proclaim the name God in front of you, right? He is faithful on his part. But on my part, in God, I found grace. It's also faithful on his part. It's easy to get grace. I know your name. I want you to pray. Before I even finish, let's rise on our feet and pray. Lord, everything I need to do that my name may reckon in your presence. Lord, help me, oh God. Can you pray? Everything I need to do that my name may reckon in your presence. Lord, give me the grace. Give me the wisdom. Every sin I need to shun, so that my name will see gain importance in your presence, give me grace. Every temptation that may take me away from your presence, that will hinder my name from being recognized with you, Lord, save me from them. In the name of Jesus Christ, Marika Zosoto Peliande, anything that will hinder me from experiencing this glory, Lord, take it away from my life. Lord, remove from my path. Give me the grace to know, experience, and walk in the fullness of the totality of this glory you are talking about, in Jesus' mighty name. I ask you for grace. I ask you for help. I ask you for mercy. I ask you for grace. I ask you for help. I ask you for mercy. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Labo Shateriande. Miregedebo Sopregeriaga. Malaboye, Gebaba Gasante, Gebaba Kundro, Bege Sante, Gedeleboye, Baba. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. We may be seated. Let me just try and round up. I'll pick it up from here tomorrow. Please, if you can do me a favor and make sure you're here tomorrow night, you're here. You know, Saturday night we have music, right? And a very short word, and then Sunday morning. It's going to be awesome. But tomorrow night, we're going to take it from there again, from where we stopped. Now, look at this that I have said now to you. When God says you will see the glory of God, it means you will see the glory of God on your life. You see the glory of God in your home. You see the glory of God on your business endeavors. You see the glory of God in your family. You see the glory of God in your midst. And all of this will happen in the name of Jesus. Amen? apply that in different dimensions to your circumstances. So when Bible says in Romans 4, verse 17 to 20, I don't have time to go into it now. When God was saying about Abraham, he said, he did not stagger in faith, but he was giving glory to God. He was giving glory to God. He knew that God would manifest. He was declaring, Lord, let your glory manifest in this situation. At the end of the day, when the baby covenant child came, glory manifested. When you look very closely in that scripture, look at verse 1 to 6 of Genesis 15. Genesis 15. Abraham could see, he could see what his barrenness, all he could see was that until God showed up. When God showed up in his glory, it was testimony galore till today. So even in barrenness, glory shows. Hallelujah. And Abraham said, Lord God, what will you give me since I go childless? And the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus. And Abraham said, behold, to me thou hast given no seed. Lo, one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, this shall not be your heir, but that shall come forth out of their own bowels, shall be their heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, look now toward heaven, and tell the stars if thou wilt be able to number them. And he said unto him, so shall thy seed be. And I believed in the Lord, and he counted it for him for righteousness. Hallelujah. Barrenness gives way to glory. So when you look at Romans 4, 17 to 20, and the Bible says Abraham was giving glory to God, was calling forth abundance, calling away barrenness. He was declaring what he believes based on verse 6 here. And then the result began to happen. So when you are talking about you will see the glory of God, don't begin to question what you are experiencing. No. Take what you are experiencing as a basis and declare what you desire as your confession. Hallelujah. That's why I took time to explain what glory meant. Is it wealth you want? Just say, Lord, I will see your glory. Is it husband you want? Lord, I will see your glory. Is it children you want? Lord, I will see your glory. Is it healing you want? Lord, I will see your glory. Is it whatever it is you want? What would you say? I will see the glory of God in the land of the living from this day forward. Can you be on your feet? Let's pray together. Let's pray together. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. At the beginning of the service tonight, the first word that we heard said that Martha was asking, Master, if you had been here, my brother had not died. And Jesus said, your brother will rise again. Martha said, I know that he will rise in the last day. Jesus said, the resurrection and the life is here. So glory is not reserved for last days. It's room for now. Anything you think had been impossible for you up until now, God wants to do it now. The resurrection and the life is here. He will manifest himself tonight, such that the last 2 weeks of this year, God will surprise you. The last 2 weeks of this year, God will surprise you. I want you to open your mouth and begin to pray. Lord, show me your glory. Lord, show me your glory. Let it show in every dimension of my life in the name of Jesus. Bring legera gang legezo zotre di soba. Megedege babaraka paligedebo sopra diaga. Reke gozo sopegede paragade. Mele bobo regege zuzo beke teke babahayaba. Le reke du zeke toriagaba. If you will believe, you will see the glory of God. Mereke du zike teriagaba. The glory of God is the manifestation of love and compassion. Glory of God, manifestation of his love and his compassion. Please pray. Lord, show me your glory. Lord, show me your glory. God is saying, I will call the word God to go before you. Shalare gebusa ragada regedosh. Please pray. Please pray. God wants to show you his glory. Let your faith receive it. Impossible cases are turning around now. God is manifesting his presence. He's changing your experience, giving you a new testimony. In the name of Jesus, men will see your wisdom. Men will favor you. Men will go before you. The presence of God will go before you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Mereko zoto. Mereke zata. Mereke zuse. Marikla debosh. Membreko zoto. Shire papalade. Malike babahando. Mereka zato. Shereke lalo. Malingre deze. Marake zuse. Merika bage. Megelibosa. Show me your glory, O God. The manifest presence of God will go before you. The manifest presence of God will go before you. Maraki kaguse kedeba babaya. Is it favor you need? Take it in the name of Jesus Christ. Show me your glory. Let the manifest presence of God go before you. Shile baboya gaba. The Queen of Sheba saw the wisdom of Solomon. Men will see your wisdom. Everything you know to do that has not been acknowledged, God begin to bring acknowledgement to them now. Everything you have done that has not been accrued to you by any means, God bring it back to the table. He begin to reward you abundantly for them. In the name of Jesus Christ, God will make men see your wisdom, and you'll be rewarded abundantly for it. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Marikabosh, Marikabosh, Maragadeze, Iklakaduba. Lord, show me your glory this year. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. I'd like you to remember that in the case of Lazarus, these were pals with Jesus. They were his ministry partners. They had become friends. What mattered to them mattered to Jesus. But it delayed 4 more days. It's not too late. It's not too late. By the time he got there, he was buried. If I was thinking. So Martha was trying to call the attention of Jesus Christ. Don't open that thing, no. Jesus said, where do you lay him? Where do you lay? You think glory will not appear again? It will come. It will come. In fact, when they told Jesus Christ of this, the Bible says Jesus wept. Jesus wept. And people were saying, how he loved him. That in itself is glory. While some say, if he loved him, why didn't you come all this while? That in itself is also going to be glory. Because they will say, though he didn't come earlier than now, when he came, it was glorious. Every delay in your life, it will result to glorious testimony. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. Begin to pray. Every delay in my life, up to this time, Lord, bring forth your glory out of it. In the name of Jesus Christ, Marekeso, Marekeda, Barikla Gabo, Sopegedia Baba, Merekle Duzike Topedia, Merekle Duzike Baba Bakayagaba. Every delay up to this moment in your life, God will take glory in it. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ, Maregego Pepegeliande, Merekladu Zeketo, Shraka, Abiro Pegedeka, Arakapapo Kedibahaya. Every delay, God will turn into glory. God will turn into glory. God will turn into glory. In the name of Jesus. Marike Soto, academic delay, marital delay, children delay, financial delay, business delay, academic, whatever delay. God take glory. God take glory. God take glory. In the name of Jesus. When this man was brought out of the grave, of the cave, Bible says, Jesus said, loose him and let him go. Before he said that, he said, he came out of the grave bound in the leg, bound in the hand, bound in the head. The vision was blurred. Can't see again because of the head is bound. The hand was bound. Everything that makes him to walk well before, nothing to show for it. The leg was bound. No progress. Every limitation in your life, in the area of your walk, in the area of your movement, in the area of your vision, in the area of your mind, may God turn it around today. May you see the glory of God in those areas. In the name of Jesus, can you begin to pray? Can you begin to pray? God, sharpen your vision. God, strengthen the work of your hand. God, prosper the hand of your hands. God, lose your feet. You begin to make progress. Progress on every side. 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 Marike Zeto, Marike Zeto, Marike Zeto, Marike Zeto, Shalabe, Berede, Marike Boso, Shendralige, Mangra Bababacuso, Pregadilaba. Let's pray, let's pray, let's pray. God is surprising us this year. Beginning from this day, progress, advancement, increase, progress, advancement, liberty, clear vision, clear sight, great speed. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. When they came to tell Jesus Christ, the man who you love is dead, what did he say? He says, when they say he's sick, he says, this sickness is not unto death, but that the Lord will be glorified. Hallelujah. He said, this sickness is not unto death, but that God may take glory in it. But can I tell you something? Jesus' word doesn't fail. No matter what sequences of occurrence happen, what Jesus said was that this is not unto death, but that God may be glorified. But do you know that he was dead? After Christ said that thing, Lazarus died. Lazarus was buried, but God still took glory. Everything that looks hopeless in your life, Jesus said it is well with your life. Everything that looks hopeless, may God's glory be resurrected now. Can you begin to pray? Every hopeless situation, the word of God says you will see glory. Therefore, glory is manifested. Your destiny is being transformed. The word of God is coming to pass in your life. Every promise God has made that looks like as if it's delayed or impossible, God is turning it around. 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 The word of God is coming to pass. The word of prophecy is coming to pass. The prophecy you had received before is coming to fruition. In the name of Jesus. Maregezoto, maregezoto, shambregeliagaba, malabo, shekete rababangeliaba, erekos sekete kababalide, mago! Bring it to pass, Lord. 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 Thank you, my Father. Lord, we give you praise. In Jesus' name, we pray. We have to stop here tonight, but pardon me, we'll take it from there tomorrow morning, I mean tomorrow evening. But I will still want us to pray this prayer. We prayed this prayer earlier, but it's very crucial. You see, God deals with the heart. If our heart can be right with God, everything outside will be clear. Hallelujah. God spoke to Moses. I will do what you're asking for two reasons. I found grace with me, and I know your name. I don't know how to explain this to you. A circumcised heart carries weight before God. I want God to know my name as someone who's after his heart. So that anything I see God in it. My life is God. When I'm at work, I speak truth. It's God. When I'm making business deal, it's truth. It's God. See, God sees in the secret and in the open. When your heart is clear before Him and He knows your name, He will lavish you with abundance of glory. So as we close tonight, I want you to pray. You see, I'm not going to have time to lay hands on anyone tonight. We're going to do that sometime along the line. But I want us to consecrate our lives to God afresh. Lord, look at my life. You know where the error is. Help me. Open my eyes to see where to fix. So from this day, what matters to you matters to me. Expose me to myself. Let me see the change I need to make. Help me so that at the end of the day, I will be qualified to carry weight in your presence. Talk to God as I bring this evening to a close. Talk to God as I bring this evening to a close. Thank you, Emmanuel. 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 Gelebo shataya gababa. Lord, help me. 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 Thank you, Father. We give you glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, we present our lives to you tonight. By any chance, now before I pray this prayer, it looks like a religious thing, but I want to just do it in case. If you are here tonight, while heads are bowed and eyes closed, if you're here tonight and you think your life is all right with God, you see, we are entering a new glory as a church and as a people, and I don't want anyone to be left out. If you're not sure you are saved, you're not sure your life is pleasing to God, and you want me to either share with me or just pray with you before we go tonight, just indicate by lifting your hand wherever you are. I want to straighten your life with God. I'll be willing to do that with you. Just lift your hand while heads are bowed and eyes closed as I close this service. So now, anyone like that? You want to straighten out your life with God by any chance? Lift your hand. I want to pray with that kind of a person. Whether you're not born again, you're not living right, you want help in that regard. Anyone like that before I pray? All right, praise God. Let's just pray. Father, we thank you for tonight. Let your word do the work. Let your word build faith in our hearts. Let your word not return to you void. I've declared, beginning from tonight, as you have asked me to do, let faith rise in the heart of your people. May we see your glory. May a better understanding come as we listen again to this message. May faith rise. As we continue tomorrow, Father God, may your presence make a difference. Lord, send your word more. Set us free from limitations. Send the name God in front of each one of us. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. We'll praise you forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Shout hallelujah. Please put